differentiate it twice, so this becomes f(2)x, okay? This gets differentiated another two times, so it becomes minus the fourth derivative of x. This gets differentiated another two times, so it's going to be plus f the sixth derivative of x. This gets differentiated another two times. Don't forget, that's the sixth derivative of f of x, so when we differentiate another two times, it's the eighth derivative of x, plus, all the way through, this term here is going to get differentiated another two times, okay, if that makes sense, yeah? So it's going to be minus 1 to the n times f of 2n of x, if that makes sense. When I add 2 onto it, I'm adding 2 onto the powers each time, yeah, okay? And then this is going to get differentiated, so it's going to be plus minus 1 of n times f of 2n plus 2. Plus 2 of x, okay? So this gives us our second derivative of this particular function that we defined here a moment ago. And what we're going to do is we're going to add these two functions together. And hopefully you can see this clearly, okay? Clearly we have, okay, that f double prime of x plus f of x, okay? This is uppercase of x. When we add these two things together, okay? Now what happens? Oh, this thing here cancels with this thing here. This thing here cancels with this thing here. This thing here cancels with this thing here. This thing here cancels with the next one, and so on and so forth, okay? Right? This here cancels. This thing here, okay, cancels with the one just in front of this, okay? This thing here cancels. Don't forget, this is going to be a negative sign here, okay? Maybe we actually can't see that actually what's happening here, yeah? So how did I get this here? I actually added on 2, okay? Well, maybe this one here just cancels with this here, okay? And I'm left with this thing that's hanging out here. So actually what we're left with is this is equal to f of x, okay, the original function f of x, okay, plus minus 1 to the n of f of 2n plus 2 of x, okay? Now don't forget, the highest indeterminant in our original function, okay, let me go back to the start here, okay, the highest indeterminant in our original function was x to the 2n. So I can differentiate this basically 2n times to bring it down to a constant. So when I differentiate that term again, another time, the constant is going to zero. So actually, this thing here, yeah, is actually equal to zero because it was the second derivative of the original constant, yeah? Okay? So actually, what we end up with is therefore we have this. We have f double prime of x plus f of x, okay? It's actually equal to our original function, f of x. Let's keep that in mind. So this is the next important. This is really, really important here for us. Okay, so this is important. Okay, so we're still moving along here. So that's really important. Let's try to see where else we're going to go to here. Yeah. Now, within the proof as well, the original proof. Let me get some more paper. Okay. Oops. Let me just get a little bit more paper here. Okay. Let me get some more paper here. Let me just put it on top here, okay? So within the original proof, okay, there was another function, yeah, that Niven actually presented, yeah, okay? So let's consider the derivative. So he presented us with a derivative, yeah? Let's consider the derivative d dx, okay, of the function f prime of x sine of x, okay, minus f of x cos of x. So let's consider this particular function here. Okay, what we're going to do is we're just going to differentiate this. So this is going to be the same as the ddx. Okay, the ddx. They're not partial derivatives now, by the way. Okay, yeah, okay. So it's the ddx of this minus the ddx of that. Okay, so it's the ddx of f prime of x sine of x minus the ddx, okay, of f of x cos of x, okay, so that's what we're going to have here. So we're going to just differentiate these, and don't forget this is the product rule here, yeah. So this is going to be equal to, well, what we have here is it's going to be, we differentiate of the, let's say, uv, so this becomes f double prime of x sine of x plus f prime of x times the derivative of sine x is cos x, okay, that gives us that, minus, and over here we differentiate this uv, u times v, let's say, so we differentiate this, this becomes f prime of x, cos of x, okay, plus we have f of x times the derivative of cos x is minus sine x, so this becomes sine x. Actually, this becomes a negative here. Okay, just keep that in mind there. That's not a plus or minus. Actually, I've lost that particular positive sign there. It's gone. Yeah. So what does that give us? Well, that gives us, you can actually see, it gives us f double prime of x sine of x plus f prime of x cos of x minus f prime of x cos of x, and minus times minus now gives us a plus f of x sine of x. Okay, so that's important, and you actually see that these two things just cancel out, so we're actually left with the function f double prime of x sine of x. You can actually see hopefully what's happening here, f of x sine of x, what's constant here, sorry, what's common across them is the sine of x, so this becomes f double prime of x plus f of x, okay, times sine of x. Okay, so you can actually see what's actually after happening hopefully here. Yeah, okay, now we've already shown, okay, in one of our previous steps, okay, I don't know where it's gone to, okay, let me try to find that, okay, whoops, okay.